So good evening, everyone, and welcome to our night prayer on this, the third Monday of Lent, Monday, the 8th of March. And today is also International Women's Day. Joining me tonight is Vivian Ross, who is from Dundalk. Vivian is involved in the parish in Dundalk with youth ministry, with the choir, with the children's liturgy, with the novena. So Vivian, it's good to connect with you again. I have memories from when I lived in Dundalk of knowing you from that time. So it's good to connect again. And Aoife Morgan is joining us from Clonard Youth Ministry, involved with all youth ministry events in Clonard. Unfortunately, there aren't many happening at the moment with the pandemic, involved with outreach and involved with the novena in Clonard as well. And please God, all of those ministries that you're involved in will be back and running soon. My name is Father Brian Nolan. I'm a Redemptorist based here in Cork, in our youth ministry community here in Cork in Scala. And again, our ministry is curtailed during these times because of the pandemic, but we're still managing to engage with some young people online, which is a fantastic tool to use, the same as we've been using these days and weeks for our night prayer. Our theme for today is teachers and educators. So we pray for all teachers and all educators as we begin our night prayer together. And as usual, each night we light a candle symbolizing our faith, symbolizing God's presence with us as we journey together and as we pray together. And I invite you, if you are watching and you have a prayer intention, to write it in the chat, and later on I'll read out some of those. So we begin. O God, come to our aid.
O Lord, make us haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
And we listen now to Psalm 85, a poor man's prayer in time of trouble. You, Lord God, are slow to anger, abounding in love. Turn your ear, O Lord, and give answer.
For I am poor and needy. Preserve my life, for I am faithful. Save the servant who trusts in you.
You are my God, have mercy on me. Lord, for I cry to you all the day long. Give joy to your servants, O Lord, for to you I lift up my soul.
O Lord, you are good and forgiving, full of love to all who call. Give heed, O Lord, to my prayer, and attend to the soul of the sound of my voice.
In the day of stress I will call, and surely you will reply. Among the gods there is none like you, O Lord. No work to compare with yours.
All the nations shall come to adore you and glorify your name, O Lord. For you are great and do marvellous deeds. You, who alone are God.
Show me, Lord, your way,
so that I may walk in your truth. Guide my heart to fear your name. I will praise you, Lord my God, with all my heart, and glorify your name forever. For your love to me has been great. You have saved me from the depths of the grave.
The proud have risen against me. Ruthless men seek my life. To you they pay no need.
But you, God of mercy and compassion, slow to anger, O Lord, abounding in love and truth, turn and take pity on me.
O give your strength to your servant, and save your handmaid son. Show me a sign of your favour, that my foes may see to your shame. Did you console me and give me your help?
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
You, Lord God, are slow to anger, abounding in love.
God chose us to propose salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us in order that we might live together with him, whether we are alive or dead, when he comes.
So we pause for a moment to allow the words of scripture, allow the words of the psalm to penetrate into our hearts and listen to God's message for each one of us.
Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit.
You have redeemed us, Lord God of truth.
Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit.
So now is the time of our evening where we bring our intercessions together. And I'm looking at another screen because I have the intercessions on the other screen. So forgive me for that. But some of the prayers that have come in this evening, Carla is asking us that we pray for her body to continue healing and for good scan results this week. Elizabeth is asking for, and Margaret indeed are asking for prayers for special intentions. As I said at the beginning, today is International Women's Day. So we pray for all women who have inspired and influenced us to be the people that we are today. Geraldine has asked us to pray for all our loved ones in hospital, especially at this difficult time in their family, in that their family and friends can't visit them during the COVID restrictions. Paula is asking for prayers for healing. Gertie is asking that we pray for her brother Jim, who passed away 3 weeks ago in the United States, and he'll be laid to rest soon. Blaise is asking for forgiveness and for new beginnings. Personal intention of my own is to ask you to pray for a friend of mine called Terry, and Terry is awaiting test results and indeed may have received those test results today in hospital. So to pray for Terry and his family at this time. Elizabeth is asking us to include her unsaid prayers and her special intentions at this time. Frances is asking us to pray for Davy McCormack, who recently has been diagnosed with cancer, and asks that we keep him in our prayers this week, and also asks us to keep Pam, who is battling with cancer, in our prayers too. Theresa is praying in thanksgiving for special intentions. And our special intention today is for teachers and educators. So we pray for those in the teaching profession. But let's also pray too for parents who have been forced into trying to be educators and homeschoolers during these times of pandemic. We Redemptorists have one school in Ireland, and I'm lucky to be connected and involved with it and a past pupil of it. But I'd like to remember the teachers and the staff of St. Clement's Redemptorist College in Limerick for their dedication and for their support to all of the students in our school. We join these petitions, these prayers, along with all of your own prayers of petition, all of the prayers of the petition that have been written on the various Facebook pages. There are 7 of them. And each night you can feel free to write in your prayer. We join them all together and we take a moment of silence just to make our own prayer and to pray for those intentions that we have listened to tonight. And our canticle. Save us, Lord, while we are awake. Protect us while we sleep, that we may keep watch with Christ and rest with him in peace. At last, all-powerful Master,
you give leave to your servant to go in peace according to your promise.
For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared for all nations, the light to enlighten the Gentiles and give glory to Israel, your people.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Save us, Lord, while we are awake. Protect us while we sleep, that we may keep watch with Christ and rest with him in peace. And let us pray. Lord God, give our bodies restful sleep, and let the work we have done today be sown for an eternal harvest, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord grant us a quiet night and a perfect end.
Amen.
So once again, thank you for tuning in and joining us for our night prayer. We'll be gathering again for the remainder of the Nights of Lent at 8:30. And we invite you to continue to come along and to invite others, encourage others to join with us virtually through Facebook. And if they don't know how to do that, if they try and connect to any of the Redemptorist Facebook pages across the country, as I say, there are 7 of them. It should pop up on their screen when we go live for our night prayer. So we'd be delighted if you could encourage others to join. Thanks to Aoife and to Vivian for helping lead us in prayer tonight. And thanks to Ryan, who's been working in the technical area in the background. We're going to conclude our evening with a Marian hymn, as is tradition, to conclude night prayer. And tonight we listen to the Clonard Choir singing the Magnificat. So good night, and God bless, and we'll see you tomorrow, please God.
My name.